everyone, and welcome to 10 for Tech, DeWitt's web show that takes up to 10 minutes to dive into bite-sized portions of technology. My name is Topez Mitchell, and today I'm going to show you how to import and export documents on your Starboard software version 9.31. To import a document, you want to start off by going to File, Open. Your Documents box will appear, and you click a document that you would like to import into your Starboard. Depending on how big your document is, this might take a while. Once your document is imported, a page size box will appear if you want to zoom in or zoom out of your document. Click OK once you're finished, and this will allow you to do whatever you want to do, such as highlighting. You can draw on it and do whatever you need to do on this document. Once you're finished and you would like to export it, you go to File, Save As, go to your second drop-down box, and as you can see, you have a variety of different files that you can save it in: HTML, JPG, PDF, and PowerPoint. I already have some slides that I've done previously that I'm going to show you how it does when you save it to PowerPoint. So you go back to File, Save As, in the second drop-down box, click PowerPoint. Save. Once it's saved, you go to PowerPoint on your desktop. Open. And when you scroll down, you should see the document that you just saved on your Starboard. As you can see, these are all the tabs that I have previously worked on. The next thing I want to show you about the Starboard is a cool thing called screen recording. This will let you basically record anything that you do on your whiteboard. By going to screen record, you want to find your menu bar and locate the toolbox with the wrench poking out. Once you click that, when you go down halfway through the screen, you will see something that says Screen Recorder. Once you click that, a box will appear. It has three buttons on this box: a record button, a pause button, and a settings button. When you click on the settings button, a box will appear. If you have a new device or a new headset that is not already installed on your computer, you might want to contact the DeWitt's help desk so they can help you install it. When it's not installed, this box will be unchecked, not allowing you to add audio to your video. Once it's installed, you can click the Enable Audio button and find whatever device you're using. Once you're finished, you click OK. When you want to start recording, you just click the Record button, and you can do anything on this board, and it will record it. Another cool thing is that you can also go to the internet, and it will also record the internet. Whatever you want to do, it will record it. As you can see, we have UNCP up. When you're finished recording, you just hit the stop button. Once you hit stop, a box will appear asking you to save it. Once you're finished, click save. If you want to open it, just go back to your documents, and you can open it up again. This is a cool thing to use if you have a student that's not in class and needs to see what happened, or a good study guide for them to use just in case they forgot something that happened in class. As you can see, it records your audio and your video. So everything I did, you see on this recording. Thanks again for joining us today on 10 for Tech. My name is Topez Mitchell, and remember, it's really not that hard.